how strange. I posted a video the other day about how I'm going to take this page in a new direction away from the 311 stuff. But yet, here we are. I'm eating my oatmeal this morning, and 311 uploads two songs while I was sleeping, and I get the notification this morning. Let's talk about these songs. Now, for the interest of transparency, I'm just going to tell you right now, I'm not going to be playing these songs in this video. I don't know that 311 would do this, but there have been a lot of copyright strikes going around different YouTube pages for, you know, reviews or tutorials on how to play music or whatever. I'm not trying to deal with that. But what I will do is link the songs below so that all you have to do is go click and you can listen like that. So the first one we're going to talk about, we're going to do this in reverse order. The second song is the first one we're going to talk about, okay? And it's called Good Feeling. I'm going to start right off by saying I don't care for this track at all. Now, the second thing I'm going to say, I have not been in a band for 30 years. I don't know what it takes to keep a band name relevant, particularly, again, after 30 years. I mean, these guys came from an era where record sales mattered, and they've been able to survive into the download age where nobody buys anything and they just listen to you on Spotify and YouTube and whatever. These guys know way more about this than I do. They probably make way better decisions than I would make if I was in that situation. But I don't feel like the pop sound works for these guys at all. Now, you could argue that they've always kind of had a poppy sound, and that's true, you know, beyond Grassroots. When you start talking about the Blue Album, they had Don't Stay Home, they had All Mixed Up, and those songs were actually radio singles that were kind of poppy. You know, Transistor Sound System, each album from that point forward, particularly from Chaos with Amber, they all had songs that you could say were poppy songs, but the thing is, those songs still sounded like 311. You knew who that was, even if it was kind of more akin to pop music in the composition and the formula of the music, you still knew that it was 311. I unfortunately don't believe that to be the case with Good Feeling. To me, this song sounds like something Nick would have made to have his kids dance to it. You know, it's a fun little poppy song with really basic lyrics, super repetitive lyrics. It's got that good old pop drum beat. Third grade level lyrics. Same kind of production tricks that Imagine Dragons and a lot of these other bands are doing right now. That being said, that shouldn't really surprise anyone because they're working with Feldman from Goldfinger. Feldman from Goldfinger produced a Blink-182 song that saw them sound like a bunch of dads playing garage rock trying to appeal to their kids. And in that context, when I say garage rock, I mean pop. I would give that song a 4 out of 10. Not the worst thing I've ever heard. It's way better than Till the City's on Fire. I really hope they never plunge that deep into the depths of just pop mediocrity grossness ever again. But hey, again, these people make way better calculated decisions than I would if I was in that position. I almost guarantee that. Overall, I just don't think this is a good one. And the reason is, that sound doesn't really fit this band. And they've even said themselves, everything we do, we gotta come original. And the day we turn to pop, the show will stop. So, alright, now for the one that I actually got the notification for. This song is called Don't You Worry. This song, I don't actually mind. It's not their strongest material, not their strongest single, but it's not bad. I mean, it's exactly what you would come to expect from, you know, hey, we're 311, we like to do our chill-out reggae rock, here's what we've been working on. And Don't You Worry is something that you would kind of expect to hear given that context. Cool drums, cool bass line, Nick and SA at the top of their game, Tim fucking Mahoney guitar solo. Everyone knows Tim Mahoney is one of the underrated guitarists in modern rock. And when he has the time to shine and tear it up, it's an amazing thing. Lyrically, this one's kind of simple too. It's a little repetitive lyrically, but it's a simple message. It's a feel-good song. And honestly, I don't think they really did anything wrong with it. I like this song. I would say that it's a 6 out of 10. Not bad, but honestly, the rock sections that, you know, it's chill for a minute and then it rocks the fuck out. I think that they did a good job of actually blending those together instead of going too far in one direction from the other, which a lot of bands do. I feel like they did a good job switching it from the chill to the heavy, you know, just killing it the same way that they did with Wildfire when, you know, that beautiful little swelling part turned into that dual harmony guitar solo. It's really, really cool the way that they've been able to always blend these styles together, but sometimes it doesn't always work. There's always an excuse where it goes from the super heavy palm muted stuff and it kills directly into the piano. That was a little weird. Not bad. I still like it, but the transition's a little bit strange. So the good news is you'll hear right off the bat here that they have continued to hone that craft of being able to mix heavy with light, and it doesn't seem forced, and it doesn't seem like it's two different songs that they just... It's not always a bad thing, because they did that with Friday Afternoon, and that shit is killer. So, overall, I'm looking forward to Voyager. Even if I'm not a big fan of when 311 tries to do pop, I still love a lot of Mosaic, even if I don't like Inside Our Home, Island Sun, Till the City's on Fire, or On a Roll. I don't know, man. I just... These guys built a career out of coming original, and in a lot of these songs, they sound like retreads of what's already popular. I don't know if that sound works for them. But hey, I'd like to know what you think. Let me know what you think. Even if you disagree with me, leave a thumbs down. I'm fine with that. I want everyone to have their opinion. I don't want to tell you how to think. Just make sure that you're thinking. Have a good day.